The earth is squishy.
That's that soft peat.
The wind is mosquito-y. And there's a flower the color of fire on the southern Oregon coast. These biologists have a boggy, buggy day ahead of them at South Slough Research Reserve. But the days are always buggy and boggy when you're hunting for the rare western lily.
Ooh, this one's showy.
Yeah, that's like a star.
The flower Hannah Schrager holds only blooms a couple weeks each year. It only lives in a slim band of swampy lowlands from Coos Bay south into Northern California. It's listed as endangered.
I mean, the reason why a lot of species are endangered is that they're dependent on a narrow set of things to survive. This has a special soil it needs, a light availability, a water regime it needs.
All those things exist here at South Slough, where the group drops down into a low-lying bog.
Oh, that's a cool. That's going to be a double flower.
This is Oregon's newest population of western lilies, only discovered back in 2013.
Probably tomorrow, this one will be open. We'll use this guy right here.
It's also one of the largest populations in the state. Madeline Vanderheiden says the exact location is closely guarded because when there's only a few thousand flowering plants left in the world, you can't be too careful. And already, lily habitat is under threat.
The lily occurs in this extremely beautiful, desirable place on the Oregon coast. As this area gets built up, wetlands are being impacted and other areas where lilies grow are being developed.
Housing, parking lots, and cranberry farming, which has expanded rapidly on the south coast, all of these compete for space with the western lily. Finding lilies in the thick brush can be challenging, even for these seasoned scientists. Relatively few plants bloom each year, and most are tiny, single-leaf juveniles.
So that's the little baby lily. Someday it'll grow up.
But once you see one...
Oh, here's one right here.
Oh, yeah.
The discoveries continue.
Yeah.
I call it getting your lily eyes on.
And even the flower can be difficult to spot. The closer you look at this boggy landscape, the more red you see.
It's such a showy flower, but when other things around it have those little color signatures too, it gives it a little bit more camouflage.
Max Beacon finds a whole new group of lilies in a hidden clearing way back in the forest, farther away than they've ever found them before.
How do we get to you?
And suddenly, Oregon's most impressive population of western lilies gets a little bit larger.
There's another one, look it.
Another juvenile.
It's an exciting day
this
here.
This is actually very cool. We'll have to expand our inventory.
These are endangered.
Yeah. Real funny, buddy.
Good days like this give the biologists hope. But the western lily is still in trouble. The Endangered Species Act doesn't protect plants as well as it does animals. Invasive plants, changing water tables, and hungry deer are adding to the pressure.
Some of the sites that were previously known to have lilies have started to blink out and decline. Despite the fact we've discovered some new populations, I think overall the trend is still downward.
And many of the lily bogs need help.
Are they flowering, Max?
No, they're not flowering.
So it makes me think that perhaps with some restoration in here, we'll open up this canopy, we might be able to get some of these young plants to flower.
Tree thinning and invasive plant removal is getting underway to open up the forest floor for the western lily at South Slough, as well as at several other sites on the Oregon coast. And the hope is that there are more lilies out there, lying asleep underground, waiting for just the right mix of water and sunlight to reveal themselves to the world.